Welcome back to another episode of Who the F***. It's the show that aims to take a deep dive into some of the acts announced for Reading and Leeds 2019. In today's video, we're looking at Anti Up. They're a house duo from the UK. If you've never heard of them before, hopefully this video will help answer the question, who the f*** are Anti Up? I'm really drunk. Anti Up are made up of two pre-existing DJs, Chris Lake and Chris Lorenzo. Chris Lorenzo is from Birmingham, Chris Lake is from Norwich. Genre-wise, we're going straight up house music. They remind me of people like Second City. DJ Zinc. Red Light. Shadow Child. The list of kind of deep and tech house artists go on and on and on and on. Justin Martin, Julio Bashmore, but you know, we don't need to list every single house DJ in the world. Individually, they started as DJs and producers with their own separate careers. I remember hearing both of their names in the early 2010s. They both had very big popular hits. Chris Lorenzo did that amazing record with Hannah Wants entitled Rhymes. And Chris Lake did that record with Steve Aoki. Boneless, which is on 97 million hits on YouTube, fuck me. But they would first collaborate as Chris Lorenzo and Chris Lake with their record Piano Hands. That was released on Ultra Music, not affiliated with the festival. They're an indie label based out of New York. Next, they would release a rework of Chris Isaak's Wicked Games. I know what you're thinking. Chris Lorenzo and Chris Lake remixing Chris Isaak. Chris Cubed? This is the description of the song. On one rainy day in Birmingham, Chris Lake and Chris Lorenzo met in the studio and produced this edit of Wicked Games. Once they got hold of the a cappella, they knew they had to build the track around it. Everything was recorded using live instruments, and they used no samples, except for the a cappella, of course. The result is this lush, vacant, but absorbent edit that is something even your mother could dance to. My mother dances to everything, so that's not really anything that special. But also, it's very, very good. I really like it. In 2015, they would release the record The Calling. In late 2017, they would release the wonderfully euphoric Nothing Better. There ain't nothing better than better than better. There ain't nothing better than us. That was released on Insomniac Records, not Insomnia Records, like Mixmag points out. Insomnia Records is a Russian psytrance label, so we'll do our best to avoid that. After going back to back at many different festivals, they decided to join forces, and so ladies and gentlemen, I present to you, Anti Up. Not M.O.P. In June of last year, they would kick this project off with the release of their single Pizza. Also has a music video to accompany it, and it's fucked up. They would then release a 3-track EP entitled Hey Pablo, and only but a couple of weeks ago released their newest single, Concentrate. I'm struggling to concentrate. This is all released on their own record label, entitled Up the Anti Record. From what I can see, it's completely independent, distributing through Label Engine, which is like this really cool website that allows you to make your own record label and distribute on things like Spotify and Apple Music and iTunes and so on and so forth, which makes this cool as shit. Their most popular record as Anti Up is the record Pizza. When does the club shut? All I want is pizza. I just want some pizza. God, I'm really drunk. Currently sat on 350,000 views, but Nothing Better, the track I mentioned earlier, is currently sat on 1.5 million views. Better than better than better. There ain't nothing better than us. the same artist, they just, it's not named Anti Up. This is their first time playing Reading and Leeds as Anti Up. However, Chris Lorenzo did play in 2017, sharing the stage with Metric, Majestic, Corrupt FM, Shy FX, Dylan Francis, and Fatboy Slim. This year, they're back to play the dance stage, playing in between Holy Goof and James Organ. WTF video for James Organ is on the way. And I think it's great to see these two guys collaborating on such a wonderful project. And the fact they're doing it all independently is just so brilliant. I really, really love that. I'm a little bit concerned that I'm beginning to shit on people that are signed to artists. Most of my favourite artists are signed to, like, big labels, but I do think that there's a lot more pride in doing it yourself, and I think that's something that should be really commended and encouraged and applauded. But this sound isn't really my thing. Concentrate and Pizza are, like, those two just, like, noisy, techie house records that just don't really do anything for me. I get why they exist, and I'm not saying that it's shit at all. It's just not something that I'm connecting with nearly 30. But I think that they're still really great records. I do think that tracks like Nothing Better are way more up my street, way more euphoric, way more melodic. That's really my kind of thing. But I've always had this kind of love-hate relationship with the deep and tech house scene. I think I'm just a bit salty because I miss electro and fidget. It's likely that they're either clashing with Frank Carter or the Distillers and Bakar. So I'm probably not going to go watch this set. Couple that with the fact I don't really like house, and three of my favourite bands on that poster that weekend are playing at the same time. They're in the danger zone and just before they even get anywhere. So I think it's pretty unlikely that I'm going to be checking out their set. So on the likely to see scale, I'm going to go with a 2 out of 10. What do you think? Have you seen them perform before? Have you seen them as individual DJs perform before? What's your opinion on the whole house scene? You know, I have kind of moaned a little bit about bassline, I've moaned a bit about house, I've praised drum and bass, and I want to understand. I'm in Australia at the moment, right, so Fish is the biggest thing in the entire world, but what I'm interested in is if house is still going strong, is it going to be a thing forever now, or what's the next cool thing that's coming in, because I'm kind of ready for, in electronic music, for some cool new underground genre to kind of come into place. Yeah, I'm excited for that. What do you think? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers. Bye.